If you're a basketball fan, you've likely heard the name Tamika Catchings.
Catchings will bring her front court by herself.
As a seventh grader, Tamika knew exactly what she wanted to do. She wanted to play in the NBA.
One day, I will be a professional basketball player in the NBA. Yeah, the NBA.
With the support of her family, she set out to make that dream a reality. In 1997, after leading her high school team to three state championships, Tamika started her freshman year at the University of Tennessee and put on a Lady Vol jersey for the first time under legendary head coach Pat Summitt.
What a talent. What just a great person. I know when I went to recruit her and we left the house, I told Mickey, I said, if we don't get this young lady, I'm going to be really disappointed because I think she's really special.
With her relentless work ethic, amazing athleticism, and infectious energy, she quickly inserted herself into the starting lineup, making a huge impact right away.
As a point guard, players like Tamika made my job easy. She could catch anything, so you put it in the vicinity. Just throw it out there and let her go get it, and I got rewarded with an assist.
She spent a ton of time on the floor just because she would be all over hustle plays and just making things happen for us.
During her time at UT, Catchings acquired many awards and honors. She was both SEC and USBWA Freshman of the Year in 1998. She was one of only two four-time All-Americans at Tennessee. She was a four-time All-SEC honoree, and she was named AP, USBWA, WBCA, and Naismith Player of the Year as a junior in 2000.
You knew the product you were going to get when you stepped across that line with Tamika, not just for herself, but for her teammates and her coaches. She was going to give you everything she had.
While on Rocky Top, she helped the team to a pair of Final Fours with an NCAA championship in 1998, as well as records of 134-10 overall and 54-2 in SEC play.
Coming into our freshman year with Tennessee coming off of a championship, Tamika, Ace, and Teresa Jeter and all of us wanted to come in and recreate that same energy and that tenacity out on the basketball court. And so just playing those games, like, we really wanted to beat the crap out of everybody we played.
That group came in and they wanted to continue the legacy. They wanted the veterans to win again. We wanted them to experience what we experienced.
Catchings etched her name in many areas of the record book at UT before making her dream of becoming a professional basketball player a reality.
My initial goal of being in the NBA, well, it shifted to being in the WNBA and playing alongside some of my heroes.
Tamika Catchings was selected by the Indiana Fever as the third overall pick in the 2001 WNBA draft. Tamika spent all 15 seasons of her WNBA career with the Fever, winning a league title and earning both WNBA MVP and Finals MVP honors and appearing in 10 All-Star games. Catchings was also a four-time U.S. Olympic gold medalist, appearing in the 2004, 2008, 2012, and 2016 games. And she became only the fifth Lady Vol to have her jersey retired on December 7th, 2003.
Watching her, I didn't just respect the talent, probably respected her work ethic more than anything. And the way she carried herself, she was just such a good person. Even with everything she's done, the gold medals, the MVPs, the Naismith, she is just meek.
That work ethic hasn't even slowed down considering what she's doing now that she's retired.
Tamika is a role model to millions, making the community in Indianapolis better through her Catch the Stars Foundation, an organization that provides youth with fitness, literacy, and mentoring programs that encourage them to set goals, dream bigger, and achieve more. In 2013, Tamika was inducted into the UT Athletics Hall of Fame. And this year, she was inducted into both the Women's Basketball Hall of Fame and the Naismith Memorial Basketball Hall of Fame.
Who better than Tamika to deserve all this? It goes so much further than just stats with her. What she has done on the court, what she did as a professional, what she's doing as a GM, and how she's grown the game. She's been able to use that platform in a positive way in our society. Tamika is so deserving, and I could not be more proud of her.
And it's just truly a blessing to think about all of the hard work and the time and the commitment and dedication to wanting to be great and being able to walk away with two amazing honors. I mean, it's just, it's a dream come true, right?